How's it going, guys? I'm your host, Karaban Gaming. Welcome back to this week's Adventure Quest release video. And this week, we actually have quite a lot of stuff going on. So first off, the Dragon Faber release is going to be delayed, which is why I'm doing the Adventure Quest release first. But the Adventure Quest release is unfortunately also going to be delayed. So we only got half of this week's release, which is the donation items for the Winter 2023 contest or what, or community drive. Okay, so we'll go through the donation items first. And then the second part of the release is supposed to be the set revamp, but according to Holo, okay, it's slated to be released at the earliest, bare minimum earliest, going to be Saturday. So we will probably not be seeing it yet. So there'll be a bit of changes to the schedule this week. I will try to do a video on that as soon as possible once the release is out. Monday is a public holiday for me, and Tuesday I'm working from home. So yeah, I should be able to get it, get the video out once the release is live. But it is one of the biggest releases we've had in probably like 10 years. So it's understandable that they need a little bit more time. There are some things that I still take issue with regards to the stat revamp. I don't know if they will see any other changes before it goes live, but I'll go through everything in more detail once we have the confirmed changes once they're inside the game. Now let us look at the donation item. So first things first, if you're a token donation winner, all of the items that you have won will have already been automatically added to your inventory, so you don't need to do anything. For the gold donation items, however, they are not automatically added. You'll need to go ahead and buy them, and you can buy them from Ballyhoo over here. Click on reward shops, contests, and here we have Heroic Titan and Nightfall Heroic Titan. So Heroic Titan is for everybody, and Nightfall Heroic Titan is for the top 100. I'm not in the top 100, so I only have access to the Heroic Titan. That's fine. The Nightfall Heroic Titan is basically a darkness version of the Heroic Titan items, but they do the exact same thing, just in the darkness element. I'll showcase the Nightfall Heroic Titan just to see how they look like. I can't showcase their effects, but they're the same effects, okay? Also, this very cool looking face over here, I have to give them props. The artwork is good. The effects wise, I don't know how I feel about it, but we shall see. There's still quite a lot of bugs going on like this. For some reason, it's only the level 5 version. I don't really know why. I think they didn't put the scaling properly or something like that. Yes, the shield. I hope they fix these bugs soon, but they have like a whole lot of things on their plate right now. They need to get the stat revamp out. The Trickster Armor bugs, they still have not fixed it. Devour Earth Shield from over a year is still pending a fix. So Winter Warden, I don't know if they still want to go ahead and tweak it, but in my opinion, I feel like they should. So yeah, there's a whole lot of things that the staff needs to get done. So I don't know how much of it is going to be done. So this is where you can buy the items. They all cost gold. Alright, let's go and check it out, and I'll give you guys my thoughts. Okay, first things first, let's go through the gold dono items since everybody will get them regardless of the amount that you've donated. By the way, you can go ahead and check out my video talking about the contest. I have two videos on it. Okay, the first one I did like way back in December, I think 5th or December 6th, and then the second video was a follow-up to the first one I just did like last week or something, like talking about how the donation drive is actually a bad idea. I've been reading through all the comments. It's quite interesting. Now, I don't like remove any comments, so I do kind of want to see what everybody thinks of my opinions. Okay, I'm not the type who will censor people. I may not agree with you, but it doesn't mean that, you know, I'm not going to allow discussion of it. Okay, I think discussion is important, and as one of the game's biggest content creators, I do want to see what the general consensus is with regards to these items. It's a little odd for me, because in the very first video I made, most people seem to agree with my points, but then with regards to the second video, it seems that most people did actually disagree with me. So yeah, a little odd over there. There's a little bit of a difference. Maybe it's different people commenting. Yeah, they're all different people commenting, so it's not like the same people from the first video came over to the second video to comment. There were a few, but for the most part, they're all different groups of people. So it's interesting to see that there are people who agree with me, and there's also people who disagree with me. I would say it's about even split so far with regards to the format of the contest. But let's go through the items. Now, the Heroic Titan weapon. So there's a melee, range, and magic version. I bought all three. The info subs are out on my Discord as well as on the Battle on Forum. So let's go through them one by one. First up, it's a melee range, dark, fire, fist, sword, stuff. All three at minus 5 BTH lean and 0.2 base damage lean. For flavor effect, It lower your MRM by 6 and deal extra 10% damage with melee and ranged weapon attacks. That's good. While the magic version boosts spell damage of the same element as the weapon by 20%. Ooh, melee ranged versions give up their no special bonus to their hits attempt to inflict a one turn something something prismatic burn on the foe. Okay, this one is just a very small chance as the baseline. This inflicts your weapon main set of a luck versus mob's dexterity of a luck. From here, all three weapons differ, but they all have toggles for specific effects. So the melee one charges 50% weapon damage and 47% melee SP, that is 184 SP. To factor in weapons, to cause your hits to attempt a 10% melee burn of the weapon's element with an infinite duration. So it's a permanent burn, okay? So yeah, so, blah blah blah. If or when you manage to get a total of 100% melee burn on this specific burn effect, the toggle switches to charging 45% melee in SP to give your attacks auto hit and causing your weapon hits to attempt a 2-turn prismatic burn. These all inflict with strength over luck versus mob's dexterity over luck with a 50% save. For the prismatic burn effect, it only starts doing this if the permanent burn is already greater than or equal to 100% melee on the first hit you're attempting that turn. First attempted hit in the turn, so also when the SP cost is charged for the effect. Okay, so regularly, hang on. I got the lucky prismatic burn right off the bat. What? Oh, okay. Oh, wait, what? Huh? What's going on? Isn't this like a... Wait a minute, let me read through the subs more carefully again. Oh, okay, so this is guaranteed. Yeah, this is guaranteed. Okay, fine. I thought it was a small chance. Maybe I misread or misremember. Okay, so you can see here, it gives out quite a lot to get this prismatic burn, which honestly is not that strong in my opinion. The stacking is also not that great. 7786. Yeah, it's like less than 100 damage. It's piss crap, but this is like just the icing on top of the cake, so don't expect too much. The minus 6 MRM to deal extra 10% damage is very nice. I love weapon effects like these. I hope that they'll introduce more min-maxing, you know, flavor effects like that. I think it really makes some of the weapons shine. The prismatic burn, however, it's not that good. So let's go ahead and test it out with the regular burn. And it's a permanent burn, so keep that in mind. So 7611, okay, it's dealing about 150 damage combined with the prismatic burn. Power 2. Oh, it's power 3. Power 4. Power 6. So it increases by power 1 every time you land a hit. And if it's successful, if it's not successful, then you don't get it. It's per hit, I guess. So you can land up to, I think, 2 per turn. I don't know. Does it go up to 4? I'm not really sure. But yeah, I think power 10 is the max. It should be the max. Okay, so now it goes on to inflict. Wait, no. Okay, it goes up to power 11. Power 12? What? There's still more? Have we not hit the cap yet? No, not yet. Hasn't hit the cap yet. Ooh, but we are running out of SP. So you can see here, it takes quite a lot of hits to reach the cap, which is not that good, I would say. But I think this is for a fully defensive build. So if you're fully defensive build, I guess you don't really mind if it takes longer time. And infinite duration is actually really, really good. The power-wise, the stacking doesn't go up exponentially, but you know, if you're playing this, you're playing a battle with a lot of turns, I guess it does slowly start to add up. So, fully defensive warrior, something for you once again. I don't know if it will be good when the stat revamp comes out, but I think fully defensive warrior is really shaping up to be a pretty nice build. So, all in all, the melee version, Not bad, but it's for fully defensive warriors, a build that still does not exist yet until the stat revamp drops. I'll go through it in more detail. And because this is, you know, available to everybody, so I guess everybody, if you're planning on changing to a fully defensive warrior, you can use this. I sort of think that maybe the staff had this in mind. I don't know if the staff planned that far ahead, like, you know, to make a fully defensive item here and then to change it to a community drive so everybody can have it. In which case, it makes it no different from a regular release in my opinion, but yeah. Next up for the shield, okay, the ranged weapon, Heroic Titan's Breaker. charges 50% weapon damage and 47% melee in SP to cause your hits to attempt a 4 turn, 25% melee burn of the weapon's element. The weapon toggles between regular HP burn and mana burn modes, and you know, you can toggle it off as well. Burn mode has attempted burn target the enemy's HP or mana burn target MP, dealing 1.5 times damage. If you're in either of the burn modes and strike an enemy with less than or equal to 0 MP, then you'll instead attempt a 4 turn something something prismatic burn. All of these inflict dexterity over luck versus mobs dexterity over luck with a 50% save. Prismatic burn is only attempted if the enemy's MP is at 0 on the first attempted hit you do that turn. First attempted hit in a turn is also when the SP cost is charged for this effect. Alright, so this is the weapon. Okay, so we already got the base burn. Okay, oh, that's the burn toggle on. Okay, I think the modes don't switch between the weapons. Okay, yeah, okay, let's do the mana burn now. Let's see. Boom, okay. Wow, one hit already took out about 200 MP. That's not bad. It should take out all of it, so I can toggle this off. And then I can toggle it on again. Inflicting a Titan's fire on. It doesn't say how much SP it causes, unlike the melee version. I kind of wish it said that. Well. Okay, so that's all your MP gone. Now I should be able to inflict Prismatic Burn, right? The burn power is decent, I would say. It's more powerful than the melee version because, you know, it's not infinite duration. But now we got the Prism Burn as well. First enemy's MP is 0, 7,000, okay, that did about 300 damage. General damage for about 4 turns, 3 turns, I guess it's alright. 5780. Yeah, I don't know. Let's do Shadow Feeder Gun, not Shadow Feeder. Power Gauntlet. Okay, Power Gauntlet works very well with Prismatic Burn because Power Gauntlet is Omni Elevound and it's extra 25% damage to all elements. And Prismatic Burn is literally all 8 elements, so you're getting a 25% boost to each hit, which adds up to, I don't know, quite a lot. Okay, so let's see now with one Power Gauntlet how far we can go. Alright, 5600. Boom. Yeah, it's still around 300. That was a little disappointing. Yeah, little disappointing. I was expecting higher. Still 300 plus. Some people, they stack this to high heaven and then they are like, ooh, the weapon is so good. But if you have to stack Power Gauntlet a bunch of times, everything's going to be good. So I'm not really going to use that as a basis for comparison. 175% now, let's see, 4148, yeah. Little bit lackluster, okay. Last but not least, VFD, Heroic Titan's Grasp, Heroic Titan's Herald, this is the magic version. Okay, so magic version, you need to cast fire spells. Do I have a fire spell here? No. So personally, I think the melee version is slightly better than the range version. The range version is a little lacking. Yeah, you need like... The melee version is because, you know, it's an infinite duration. Whereas the range version is not infinite. But of course, keep in mind, all of these testing is done against the combat practice trainer. So I think against a proper monster, maybe... Just maybe the ranged version would be better because the permanent version, this is assuming the monster doesn't save. If the monster saves against the effect, then yeah, your permanent burn is gone. So the ranged version gives you more power, which is better in my opinion. Wait, can you save after it? No. Scratch what I said. Yeah, scratch what I said. Never mind. I think I'm still half asleep. Sorry, guys. I slept pretty late last night. But, yeah, it looks like the melee version is better. Okay, yeah. Melee version is still better because the monster can't... Once you inflict the burn, the monster can't save against it anymore. Click. Okay, resuming normal casting. Alright, now the magic version charges 100% melee in SP to have spell hits that match the weapon's element to attempt to inflict either a 4-turn 25% melee burn of the weapon's element or a 4-turn blah blah blah, prismatic burn. You can toggle the weapon between burn and prismatic burn modes. However, if the prismatic burn has been attempted, you must attempt 3 turns worth of the normal burn infliction to enable use of the prismatic burn mode. If you are in the prismatic burn mode and don't have enough charges for it, instead just do the regular burn. Okay. And the elemental realm's power. So this is prismatic burn. Let's try prismatic burn first. Can you do it right off the bat? I think you can, right? Yep, you can. Okay, but I need to wait 3 more turns to get it. Okay, 2.483. Ooh. Oh wow, okay, finally, something good. That's about 800 damage. Yeah, it is a pretty hefty SP cost, don't get me wrong, but that's like, what, 800 damage right off the bat? Whoa, that's good. That's actually good. And mages, you don't really care about that, you just care about bursting the enemy down as quickly as you can, so... Wow, okay, the magic version is pretty good as well. Assuming you have the resources to upkeep it, okay. Armor casting, let's look at the regular fire burn. Regular fire burn, doesn't look that good. 8,000, okay. 600, oh, hang on. Oh wait, no, this is still prismatic burn, what? It's already, wait, what? Normal casting. Yeah, I want normal casting. Wait, why is it still doing priest burn? Is it bug? Okay, some of these items are bugged, so it's not really my fault. Yeah, it's not that I don't want to showcase it or I'm doing it wrongly. I think I'm doing it correctly. It's just that some of these items are bugged. There's quite a lot of bugs actually, so I don't know if I'm doing it right or not. Resuming normal casting. It says normal casting here, right? Pretty sure it's not a double click issue with my mouse, but yeah, okay, it's bugged, okay, so no matter what mode it is, yeah, here's the thing with the bugs, it's very confusing for someone trying to do the showcase. I keep thinking if I'm doing something wrong, but honestly, I think it's just the items being bugged. Okay, let's look at the shields now. The shield, Heroic Titan's Inspiration, Dark Slash Fire Shield, Mastercraft is a toggle that charges 25% melee in SP, the first time each turn, the enemy attempts an attack on you. For that strike and each strike in that turn, anytime you are hit, you attempt to inflict a 2-turn melee percent melee prismatic burn. Blah blah blah, this inflicts your weapon main stat over luck versus the enemy's dexterity over luck. Neutral save. This can trigger up to 4 times per turn. Heroic Titan is the fire version and available for gold. Dark Titan is the scaling dark version given to top donators. Okay, let's test this out against a regular monster because CPT will always have a hard time trying to hit me. Let's start. Nothing. Oh, I need to toggle it on. Okay. And now prismatically burn your foe each time they strike you. It's one hit. One hit is 0.242. Okay. So 2.3k. That's about 100. Kind of bad. Yeah, pretty bad. Maybe you find something with more hits. So this will give me 2 hits. Still not sure if that's good though. Yeah, Draco Air Raiders all have 1 hit attack. Okay, next. Ted Zart. Okay, we got 3. Okay, 3 is fine. Let's do 3. Attack me. Oh my god. Oh, freaking hell. Every damn time, I swear to god. Stupid game. They kill off one. Yeah, I killed off one guy. Oh wait, okay, never mind. This one hits multiple times. Okay. 242? Not fantastic. Yeah, it's a pretty weak burn, but it is prismatic burn. Shield, not so good. Alright, last but not least, miscellaneous item. The Heroic Titan's Pledge, Dark Slash Fire miscellaneous item, gives resistance to the item's element, capping at 0.5 times damage taken for the scaling version, and plus 20 burn and prismatic burn potence. Oh, there's prismatic burn potence as well. So for those of you who aren't aware, burn and prismatic burn are two completely different statuses in the game. Even though they have the word burn inside of the name, okay, burn and prismatic burns are treated differently. Alright, so let's go ahead and bring that out. Right, am I right to say that? This adjusts to the usual. The prismatic burn potence, I'm not seeing it. Does it count as the same one? Okay, I don't know. Causes 5% melee total for the potence effects, already factored into the below numbers. Mastercraft compresses a toggle that heals you for 10% melee when you successfully strike a strike a foe suffering from burn or prismatic burn. This causes 20% melee per turn and is only charged when the toggle is activated, you attempt a weapon special or spell attack on a foe, and the foe has burn or prismatic burn inflicted on them. It doesn't get the 0.9 times always useful penalty since it's tied to an elemental item. It doesn't get the auto hit 0.85 times penalty since it requires you to land a hit to trigger. Healing effect can trigger up to 4 times per turn. Okay, so let me just go ahead and cast a spell or something and then we'll burn the foe. Let's do this. Okay, so nice, we got pretty powerful burn. Let's go ahead and heal up here. 4 hits, right? Okay. Let's see how much damage it heals. Let's go into Wishweaver so we get a maximum 4 hits per turn. Items, Titan's Pledge, Dismount, and let's just attack. So 2615. What? Okay, it's not healing me. Wait, I need to toggle it on. Oh, okay. I forgot to toggle it on. Okay, so 2582. It's about 100. It's about 100. 4 hits, 100 HP. It's kind of weak. That's actually really weak. Wow, okay. Little bit disappointing there. 2603. Okay, it's about 150, I would say. Yeah, averaging about 150. Let's go again. 2763, 2829. Yeah, it's about 150 for 4 hits. Not good. Healing's not good. Burn potence is useful, but we do have other items with burn potence as well. The standard resistance thingy, that's kind of useless. Literally every single miscellaneous item has that. Not great. Alright, the weapons, I think they're alright. Shield is pretty shitty, and so is the miscellaneous item. Now let's go and check out the token donation items, okay? So gold donation items overall. The burn is okay, prismatic burn is nice, but like only the weapon. The shield's burn is too weak. The miscellaneous item isn't doing enough, especially the healing aspect. But the, yeah, I think the weapon is really the star of the whole show for the set. Okay, all in all, I think I'll give the set a 7 out of 10, and it's mostly hard carried by the weapon. Okay, the shield and miscellaneous item is just downright bad. So, yeah, the weapon. Weapon is really good, okay, the rest are just meh, and it, because it's burn, it's a damage over time effect, so it's mainly for defensive builds. If you're not a defensive build, I guess this won't really be useful for you. Okay, so for winter donation, we have the autumn items. Okay, so first up, the autumn's charm, longing, and grace. It's a mastercraft, wind, melee sword, range bow, and magic sword, melee and magic, zero proc. Instead of the usual 1.08 times damage, no proc boost, it has the following effect. When attacking, there's a 5% chance of the weapon dealing extra damage. At the end of your turn, the mob is burned. 4 turns, power 5.7. Ooh, it's pretty strong, but it's only 5% chance. The mob can resist with a save at minus 20 penalty. Wow, this is actually a really strong effect, so you're dealing. Oh, wait, what? Oh, it should be triggered. I am so lucky. I am so lucky, guys. 250 plus and it dealt extra damage. That's not bad. Wow. Okay, nice. That's what I'm talking about. That's what all showcases should be like. You know, I'm proccing the effect that I want to showcase on the first turn. Okay, that's a pretty good effect. Yeah, I quite like it. And it comes with a toggle. Has 3 options. Default, standard damage. Second toggle, your attacks take minus 25% melee damage and you pay 181 SP and 161 HP and weapon damage to stun your foe. Okay, it has a pretty hits over attempts chance of paralyzing your foe for one turn. They can resist with a save at minus 50 penalty. So a lot of people think this is great because it is almost guaranteed chance to stun foes, which is nice definitely, but most foes nowadays, or at least the tougher ones that actually matter, they have a lot of freedom. So this is not going to be that useful. But the third mode, the third mode, your attacks take a minus 25% melee damage, and you pay, how much SP do you pay? 193 SP and weapon damage. Okay, to inflict a wind burn, 3 turns, power 5. The mob has freedom, the power is multiplied by 1.15. Otherwise, it's multiplied by 0.9. Mob can resist with a save. So I think it's really good that they added this in. You know, if mobs have freedom, then you know, you get a power boost. I think this sort of covers up the weakness for the second toggle. The second toggle, you know, it only works against monsters that can be stunned. And chances are you will be able to easily stun monsters using any other items to begin with. So I would say that's not super useful. But for this one, because they added that in, I think it's great. You know, at least you make it usable against bosses. So good job on the staff for thinking, you know, ahead and giving us this boost against monsters with freedom for a stun item. Okay, that actually makes it worthwhile to use. Next up, let's do range. Okay, so range. Autumn's Longing, sorry, is the bow. Okay, 100 proc, instead of the usual 1.1 times damage, no real special boost, it has the following effect. When attacking, there's a 5% chance of the weapon dealing times 3, well, multiplicative, and minus 66.7% additive damage. At the end of your turn, the mob is burned. 4 turns, power 7.1. Whew! Mob can resist with a save at minus 20 penalty. Wow, the bow. The bow is crazy, man. And you also have all the toggles that you have from the melee weapon. The toggles are all the same for all the weapons, but wow, the bow is really good, I think. Okay. Engulf and Burning Winds. Oh, propped again. Wow, I am so lucky today. So lucky. Wait a minute. It's not 7 point. Wait, this is only 4.5. Why is that so? Oh, because I toggle it on. Oh, I need to deactivate it, okay. Yeah, okay, so this is the stun. Yeah, all of the toggles, they carry over between the weapons. Oopsies, I thought I managed to proc the special again, so I need to toggle it off. Okay, let's deactivate the burn mode. Give me the proc. Oh, is that... Okay, no. Okay, so the regular one is the 2-hit instead of the multi-hit. I kind of want to see the special going on. It's only 5% chance, but god damn, it's powerful. Like, holy crap. 4 turns, power 7.1, and you're dealing so much extra damage. That's nuts. Oh, there we go. Okay. Ooh, 300. Yeah, wow. This is a really good bow for rangers. Probably the best in slot for win. If you have this. Yeah, definitely. Oh my god. Wow, really, really nice defensive bow for rangers. Defensive build is getting a lot of love this time round for both donation contests. Okay, and then for magic. Magic is the same as the melee one. Yeah, the magic is the same as the melee one. Nothing much to talk about, I guess. But does it... Magic, is it also inflict with attack? I think it's also inflict with attack rather than spell cast. Let me see. Take a wind burn, okay. Yeah, okay, so the magic one is a little odd. It requires regular attacks. I sort of wish they changed the magic one to spell casting instead. That'll make a lot more sense. But yeah, once again, the weapon, I think they're pretty good. Because, you know, you can use the stun against non-bosses, and against bosses, you have the burn. The burn, I would say, is not super powerful, but better than nothing, that's for sure. And I think it's decent. You do have to sacrifice quite a lot of resources, which is the unfortunate part. But it's nice that they split it up between SP and HP, so it's not too taxing on any single resource. I love that they are splitting up costs like that. That's a good thing. Okay, and then we have the shield. Takes minus 3 blocking. If the monster is burning, takes minus 10, you take minus 10% damage and minus 3 BTH. Okay, I think there's a little typo here. In the info subs, and the monster has a wind burn, then it takes a further, then you take a further minus 10% damage. So what? You take minus 20% damage if the foe has a wind burn. I don't know how I feel about that. Yeah, okay, wait. You don't have to toggle on the shield. The shield is, there's no toggle. Yeah, the shield is really bad. Really, really bad. Not worth. Okay. Last but not least, we have the miscellaneous item. Okay, miscellaneous item, Spirit of Autumn. And this costed me 90,000 tokens. It will cost you around 80 to 85,000 tokens minimally, okay, to get this miscellaneous item. It toggles between wind and earth resist. Some people think, you know, double resistances are good. I think it's just very situational. How often will you encounter a boss that will hit for two different elements with two different turns? And in which case, if they are splitting up the element attacks into different turns, then you can just use a different miscellaneous item rather than, you know, having it compressed into one. If it defended against both at the same time, then sure, there could be an argument that it would be useful. But, you know, because you're switching in and out, I think it's not that great. It also grants a standard boost to strength and a smaller boost to endurance. Okay, so again, this is for warriors, fully defensive warriors, wins once again, even though the build is not already out. It's also stated to have a damage buff. The buff is funneled into the following effect. At the end of your turn, if you attack with a weapon or spell, the monster becomes burned. Win 2 rounds. The burn power is equal to the buff. The monster can resist with a save at plus 0 bonus. Inflict with weapon main stat of a luck versus resist with an dexterity of a luck. So level 150 stats, you get 50 strength, 35 endurance, 0.5 times wind or earth resist, 20% melee going into the burn, causes 87 SP per turn. Not fantastic. Yeah, not fantastic. Let's see how much burn we can get. 6.58. 316. 356. Yeah, the burn scaling is pretty bad. Probably just do it once and forget about it. Miscellaneous item very lackluster considering the cost you have to pay for this. I don't regret because I willingly chose to donate that many tokens to get a miscellaneous item. Just so I could do the showcase video for you guys. But in terms of the amount spent, yeah, this is 100% not worth the tokens. 90,000 tokens, I'm expecting something of like optical, power gauntlet, essence orb level, shadow feeder pendant level, but instead we get this piece of junk here. Yeah, so for those who didn't get this, don't need to feel left out. In fact, you should be happy because you didn't waste like over 80,000 tokens on this piece of crap here. The weapon, however, the weapon I think is pretty decent. The shield is kind of shit. So, token, for both token and gold, the best items out of the set are undeniably the weapons, okay? The shield is pretty weak. Yeah, for both of them, I think the shields are no good. And the miscellaneous items, they are both also not very good. So, yeah, really, the winners here are just the weapons. The weapons, let me see, what... top, what do you need? What's the top placing you need to get the weapons? Okay, so... oh yeah, everybody gets the weapons here, so it doesn't matter. If you're top 100, you get a different variation. And then the top 100, you get the weapon. Yeah, top 100 should be very doable, right? Let's see. Very, very doable, I think. If you only got up to top 100, you are a big fat winner, okay? 28,600. Okay, that's still a pretty... large amount for most people who are not whales, but I would say for this amount for that weapon, I think it's worth it, especially if you're a ranger or a fully defensive ranger or are planning to play a fully defensive warrior in the upcoming stat revamp changes. If you're either of those two builds, you are really winning hard, okay, with these donation contest items. Majors not so much because majors most of the time focus on bursting, so all these damage over time burn effects is not really that useful for a mage build. But yeah, fully defensive rangers, fully defensive warriors, you had it good this time round. Hopefully we get something for majors next time round, pretty please. I mean, we did get something pretty decent last summer donation contest. I'm assuming we'll get another something else this donation contest, but we'll see. Alright, so those are my review on the items. Hope you guys have enjoyed the video. If you have, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. And of course, subscribe to this channel if you guys would like to see more of such future content. Till the next time, I'm your host, Corban Gaming. Peace out.